know what to do, girl. Blow it. That's my lady. Saddle.
Those plans make any sense?
Oh, sure.
Seems easy enough, I think.
How hard can it be?
But I'll tell you what I think, just to be safe. I'll do the reading and planning, and you do the building.
How did I know you'd try to weasel out of doing any work?
Oh, now, that is plain unfair. It's inaccurate and not what's going to happen. I'm simply going to use what I've got, which is a brain. While you use what you've got, which is less of a brain.
Let's get started.
Well, first thing it says the foundation, which involves moving those heavy wooden joists. Definitely not a job for a man with terminal lumbago unless you want to dig a 6-foot-deep hole for me when the work day's over.
Don't tempt me.
Oh, well, here comes Charles. Maybe he can lighten the mood a little.
How'd you get on?
He'll be back, but not for a while.
Charles, dear boy, John needs help moving these joists. Now, come on. Get a move on. We gotta get started before the rains come.
You're very annoying.
He's right. We should get on with this.
may have a rule and a song.
And I think that's everything.
John Marston, you have a home.
So do you.
Oh, I know.
And you, Charles, as long as you'll stay with us.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, to this happy home. Well, at least till this fool gets his woman back.
My darling Abigail, I hope you and Jack are doing well. I remain a fool, and I'm sure I shall die a fool. But I'm trying very hard to be something like the man you deserve. I have done something very silly in an effort to impress you, and that is, I've purchased a home. The land you read about in the newspaper up at Beecher's Hope is now ours, and we are going to try our hand at ranching. Mr. Geddes kindly helped me buy the land. I met Uncle while I was coming out of the bank, and while I know your feelings about him, he has been enormously helpful in his own fashion. Charles Smith has also appeared and is unsurprisingly a pillar of strength. Together, we've built you a home. I hope soon to show it to you. I miss you and the boy more than I can express. Please, come back to me. Yours always, John. Uncle, I thought you was... Where the hell? Got an appetite.